Hey, good morning. Today we are going to look at the evaluation of your paper introduction and also to see the progress of your slides that you're going to prepare for the 3 minutes talk. So before we proceed with the evaluation on your slides draft, I'm going to show you first the evaluation of the paper introduction that you already submit in 2 weeks early, okay, in 2 weeks ago. So let me share you the screen instead. Okay, so overall, I'm appreciating that all of you have done a good effort in terms of trying to write the composition, even though the introduction itself is relatively short compared to the whole paper that you need to submit in the last week of our class, but still improvement can be done in terms, especially in terms of the language, whether it's in the usage of certain scientific vocabulary or in terms of the English grammar itself. Okay, so as a starting point, I'm considering that the thing that you already done is good, okay? And then I'm going to grade your intro paper as good, okay? But still, improvement can be done. And I'm hoping that those improvements could be shown during the submission of your final paper in the last week of our class. In order for you to improve the quality of your writings, especially in terms of the language, I'm suggesting you to restudy or review the thing that you already learned in high school, especially in terms of the English grammar. Especially in the section of subject and verb agreement, because it is kind of obvious for a reviewer to see inside of a certain manuscript whether the subject of a certain sentences is plural or singular, so that the verb itself needs to be adjusted in terms of the subject itself. And then please revisit the lecture notes that I've already gave you in the previous couple of weeks, especially related to the differences between sentences, clauses, and I don't remember. So make sure that what you write in the paper must be a full sentence. Okay, it could not be a hanging phrases or clauses, because a perfect sentence needs to have one subject and one predicate or verb. Okay, and it has to be clear. It has to be clear. And if you are writing in a compound sentences, or sorry, a compound sentence, make sure that you have the appropriate conjunction between one part of the sentence to the other. Okay. So, for example, when you are using and, or, however, even though, although, something like that, please make sure that you write or you choose the correct conjunction in order to make the complex sentence more properly. And then the second note that I noticed from all of your work is that many of you write the wrong affiliation, not the wrong affiliation, but because probably you are not aware of this, so I'm going to tell you about the about how to write the correct affiliations. But I want to point out that many of you write the wrong province of the province where ITB exists, okay, or located. It is in West Java province. I noticed that many of you are copying Lulu Fauzan's manuscript or introduction paper that I gave you 2 weeks ago, yeah. But that is just for example, right? But you have to think whether the location is correct or not, because ITB is located in Bandung, and Bandung is located in the West Java province, not East Java province. I can show you an example. Okay, by the way, all of the paper, I've already make some notes on each paper and write some feedbacks that you may use for the improvement of your paper later on. But I'm just going to show you an example, for example, from Nabila. Okay, I'm going to talk about the physics department later on, but here, for example, East Java province, for example. Well, Bandung is located in the West Java province, right? East Java here, I guess you are copying Lulu Lyo Fauzan's introduction paper. So many of you use East Java. Okay, please be critical because you are I think all of you knew that Bandung is located in West Java. So please use the proper or the correct province for the city, right? Okay, so for email address, you use Gmail, which is okay for an exercise, but if you are writing later on, for example, if you are writing for a scientific paper that you submit into a certain publisher, whether it's in local, national, or international publication, please make sure that you have the correct affiliation on the campus. Even though it is okay, because I also see some examples in international journals that people also use their personal Gmail account or Yahoo account, etc. So, but most of them, okay, the majority use their institution email. So if you have the institution institutional email that ITB has provided you since the beginning of your study year in TPB, please use that because it is more formal for you to publish a certain scientific paper using the affiliation of your institution's email. Even though using a Gmail or Yahoo account or Hotmail or Microsoft email account is also it is not prohibited, but it is more formal to use the institutional email instead. Okay, so let me see another example for Muhammad Raka. Here, this is also exists that you write East Java province instead of West Java, and then it is a common is a common mistakes that many of you have in writing the affiliate, in writing the address of ITB. Okay, this is also the same, East Java instead of West Java. Okay, please. So remember, ITB is located in Bandung, and Bandung is located in the West Java province, not East Java province. Even though I knew that in East Java there is a city called Bandung, or a region, or a village, or a district called Bandung, but ITB is located in the Bandung city, right? In the West Java province since 1920. So make sure that you don't do the same mistakes in the future. Okay, so moving on to the note on affiliation. Okay, I noticed that most of you write the affiliation. Well, I guess you are following Lulu Laila Fauzan's introduction. So you use physics department. Unfortunately, we don't have any physics department formerly. Okay. Well, in the past, we do have a physics department because the structure of ITB in the past is using department. But now, physics, the formal name of physics is currently writes as Bachelor of Physics Study Program, or Master of Physics Study Program, or Doctorate of Physics Study Program. So if you are going to use physics department, quote unquote, as your affiliation, make sure that you are writing the proper name for the study program, because currently because currently the name, or the proper name of the study program, is the Bachelor of Physics Study Program instead of Physics Department. Yes, it is true that in the past we do have Physics Department because ITB is structured into departments, but now ITB is structured in faculty, and then after faculty is the study program alongside with the research division. And talking about the research division, it is more common, especially when you are writing a research paper, that you mention the affiliation into your research division. Okay, so instead of using physics, instead of using Bachelor of Physics study program, it is better for you to use your KAKA, or kelompok keahlian, or research division. So for example, if you are working under the supervision of Mr. Alam Tasingarimbun, for example, then your affiliation should be the KAKA Fisika Bumi dan Sistem Kompleks, for example. Or if you are working under Professor Yogi Dharma, for example, then your affiliation should be KAKA Fisika Material Elektronik. Or if you are working under Pak Agus Roso, then your affiliation should be KAKA Fisika Teoretik Energi Tinggi, for example. Right. So writing the affiliation, it is okay for you to use Bahasa Indonesia because that is the proper. Well, you can use the Indonesian name for the KAKA and also for ITB itself, because I think the English name for ITB and also the research division under FMIPA, especially related to the physics. Most of our research division has their own English name. So for example, for kelompok keahlian fisika bumi dan sistem kompleks, it is called as the Earth and Complex System Physics Research Division, and then the FME, okay, FMA, KAKA FMA is called as the Electronic Material Physics, Electronic Material Physics Research Division, and the rest of the Research Division in FMIPA has already have already the English name for each research division. So you must look up their names so that you can write the proper affiliation on the paper. In terms of the regulation from ITB itself, I think there is an example that was written in 2016 or 17 that is used. Okay, so this is the example. So I think this was the manuscript that many faculty use until today until this year on how they write the proper affiliation in scientific in a official scientific publication, okay, in the authorized scientific publication. It was produced by the FTMD of ITB, but nowadays it is used by many faculty. Okay, so if you are writing an international journal written in English, for example, you should write it as the your name, and then your research group, and then your faculty, and then Institut Teknologi Bandung, and then the address, Jalan Ganesha 10, Bandung, 40132, Indonesia. So you don't need to write the province or the city of Bandung on your affiliation. So here, okay, the writing of this one should be corrected, okay, should be modified into the correct one. And the correct one is just like this. So your name, okay, so let me show this one and this one. So you already have your name here, and then the affiliation should be your research division. For example, Kakak Fisika Bumi, okay, Kakak Fisika Bumi dan Sistem Kompleks, and then Institut Teknologi, and then FMIPA, and the FMIPA is written in English as written here in an example. So, or if you already, or if you knew if you knew the English name for your research group, then use the English name for submitting to the international journal. So, for example, in Kaka FBSK, it is the Physics of Earth and Complex System. Okay, Physics of Earth and Complex System Research Group, Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Sciences, comma Institut Teknologi Bandung, Jalan Ganesha 10, Bandung, 40132, Indonesia. Okay, so this is the proper way. Okay, I will give you later on how you use the names and affiliation, the proper writing of your affiliation that is commonly used in ITB, okay, in ITB. And then here also in the notes, there are examples that showing you the improper way of writing your affiliations. Okay, so for example, if you are writing Bandung Institute of Technology, like this one, Bandung Inst period of Technology, it is wrong. And then Institute of Technology Bandung is also wrong. Institute of Technology, comma Bandung is wrong. And all of this example given here is the wrong way to write your affiliation. So the proper way to write it is you can use Bahasa Indonesia version, this one, or the English version, this one. Okay. So later on, if you are writing your affiliation, please aware that you need to write it in the proper way. So that, because if it's written properly, whenever a nowadays, if you are looking for journals in Google Scholar or in Scopus or in Web of Science, the numbers, okay, the numbers of publication per university will be done by looking at the affiliation. So if so, in order for us to have a higher grade of our institution, okay, because it is related more on the on the institutional grading, or because every year institution like the Times Higher Educations, and then I forgot what is the evaluation, Webometrics, and then Times Higher Education, Webometrics, and many other institutions that publish the ranking, okay, that publish the ranking of the universities throughout the world, will compute the output of the research based on publication. And in order to do that, they look upon the institution name, okay, the institution name. And for ITB, you should write it as Institut Teknologi Bandung, okay, Institut Teknologi Bandung, and the and also the faculty, okay, needs to be written as for FMIPA, it is the Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Science. And the more publications made during a certain time, it will basically increase the ranking of a certain university based on their publication. And the way that they look for the publication ranking is by looking how many papers published using the proper affiliation. So if you are writing Institut Teknologi Bandung as Bandung Institute of Technology or Institute of Technology Bandung, the ranking institution will consider this as a certain university, not from ITB. Okay, so so in order for us to basically to decrease the variety of our institution name, just write it in Indonesian. Okay, because Institut Teknologi Bandung is already known in the world by its Indonesian name. Okay, even though in the past, okay, this is from the experience from the past, it is true that many authors from ITB write the affiliation as Bandung Institute of Technology, because they are referring to Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT. So they write the affiliation as Bandung Institute of Technology. Well, I think since this memo, or since this guide was published in 2016 or 17, all of the paper that is submit to the international journal now use the Institute of Technology Bandung. Okay, so so even though in the past many researcher or many lecturer or students use Bandung Institute of Technology, but the proper way to name this is the Institute of Technology Bandung. Okay, is there any question from the students regarding these writings, especially on the affiliations? Okay, if we are looking at the examples, I don't know whether Jessica, let me go to the okay. For example, here in I don't know whether the Okay, so it's working. So here for Physics of Earth and Complex Systems, PETS, it is the English name for Tata Fisika Bumi and System Complex. But I want to look for other affiliation. Let me go to FMIPA website and then look for the research division names. For example, here, okay, profile. Okay, profile. Is there any kelompok ilmuwan? Okay. Okay, so for example, electronic material physics, and then the physics of magnetic and photonic, and then nuclear physics and biophysics, and then this one is the high energy theoretical physics. This is physics instrumentation and computation. Oh, okay. So FIK hasn't got their website ready yet. So let me go for this one. Okay. So for FMA, the English name for their research division is the Physics of Electronic Material. Okay, and then for this one, okay, there's some kind of a problem here. Proceed. And then for nuclear physics, they are written as physics of nuclear and biophysics. And then for theoretical high energy physics is written in this name. Okay, written in this name. And then, okay, so let me see. Welcome to the Kaka Fisika Magnetic and Photonic. Is there any English translation for this one? Unfortunately, okay. Physics of Magnetism and Photonics. Okay, Physics of Magnetism and Photonics Research Division. Is the proper way to write the research division of FMF. Okay. So if you are looking on the each research division's website, then you should see the English translation of the research division name. So use that. And also the faculty is relatively easy because it is written as Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Sciences. But ITB is still written in ITB or Institute of Technology Bandung. Okay, it's not Bandung Institute of Technology. Okay, so this one. Okay, please look for the feedback that I've provided you in the feedback folder. There are some papers that I consider perfect. Well, perfect means that the mistakes are relatively negligible. Okay, because myself is not the master of the English language per se. Because I'm just looking for the content itself. But if I'm seeing that there is some kind of a disagreement between a certain verb and subject, that I will address that, etc. and so on. Most of you basically able to write the introduction properly. But there are some kind of a thing that need to be addressed here, especially in terms of the affiliation of the introduction. So later on for the for the slide draft and also for the paper, the final paper, please use the proper affiliation. Okay, so let me see. References. Okay, so here I noticed that There are two types of references that are used in the introduction. Well, the one that I show you here is an example of references that is written without using number. Okay, and then when you are writing the references without number, then you don't need to worry about the order. You just need to write the references, for example, like this one, Curry et al. 2020, Wilensky 1999, and Yang 2011. So you don't need to worry about the order of the appearance of the references in the body of your paper. But let me see another example. Well, okay, this is from Muzaki, and I think you already write so many things here, but I just need to evaluate your introduction, okay? And there are typos, obviously, if you look at it. So I don't need to look for the hardware or tensile test. Okay, so I'm just going to close this and look for, because I'm still talking about the references, how you use the references in your body of your paper. Let me see, from Rivka. Okay, so this is the example of paper that use numbers. Okay, so if you're using numbers, then the proper way to cite this is by numbers in order, okay, in the order of the appearance in the body of the paper. So even though the first name of the author, it is not alphabetically ordered, it doesn't, it is okay, because if you are writing in this format, the appearance, okay, the appearance of this references is more important than the arrangement of the author's name. Okay, so here you can see the differences between the reference give in the names and year format, and this one is by the appearance. Okay, so here. The second sentence, this is due to the location of Indonesia. What is the correction here? Oh, sorry. The correction, The correction is, this is due to the location of Indonesia, where it is in the Asia Pacific Volcanic Road, which is a path prone to seismic activity, reference number one. And then the fourth sentence, this movement is the leading cause of earthquake activity in Indonesia, reference number two. So you can see here that the first reference, it is written by the group from National Geographic, and then the second one is coming from Irjanan Haris. Okay, so here the writing of your references is not following the alphabetical order of your names, because if it's following the alphabetical order of your name, then Haris should be first, okay, or any other names that followed by A, okay, by the letter A should be written in the first references, but here it doesn't, because it follows the order of the references that is appear in the body. So if this sentence is referring to this publication, then this publication becomes number one, okay, and then if you already have number one here, and then you're going to recite your publication later on, then you just call them number one at any point on your body. So it is still okay to use the same reference For the later part of your body of paragraph of paper, but it needs to be addressed first in the top. Okay, so after you mention it in the top, then if you're going to recode again, then it's okay. Okay, so please keep in mind that if you are choosing to use this type of references. List of references, then the order should be coming out from the references that coming out first in the body. Okay, and this is the alternative. Okay, I'm telling you this because there are examples that in the paper the references is not starting from one. Okay, because the references after it's get numbered like this one, and then it is written in alphabetical order of their last name. And so the appearance of the references in the body, it is not starting from one, but sometimes it is starting from seven, starting from 20, etc. And this is, and maybe there are some publications who use that type of format, but it's not common, because the common one is that you use the number one as the first paper or the first book or the first monograph that you use as the basis of your statement over here. So so here, if it's appear is number, it means that the reference here is basically telling about this one. Okay. And this one is telling this one, and this one is telling this one. So it's based on the appearance. Okay. And obviously the simplest one is like this one. Okay. Based on the names. Okay. But I guess some of the recent publication, people are tend to change from this type of writings of their publication into this one. Okay, so you must learn how to write the references in two type of styles here, so that whenever you're changing from one publication to another, because probably one publisher have different rules than the other one, so than the other publisher, then you need to adapt, you need to able to change whenever the rules of the writing is changing between one publisher and to another publisher. Okay, so these are the common mistakes, okay, that I noticed from your paper introduction, but I'm going to acknowledge that most of you done a very good job in terms of writing the introduction. So please continue the hard work for the final paper that you need to submit in the last day of our class. Okay, the last day of the regular session. Okay, not on the last session of the semester, because in the last session of the semester, which is the day of our final exam, you need to send me the, okay, while I'm talking about this, because here you already done this one, right? We already done this one, and we're going to have presentation one in Thursday, okay? And the full paper will be compiled in the last session of the presentation three. Okay, so the last day of presentation three, is going to be the submission day for your full paper. However, for your poster presentation, the submission date usually taken in the final exam day. Okay, so and the final exam will be in the weeks of Let me see. Let me see the academic ITB and then academic calendar. Okay, so the final exam. The final exam week will be done in December the 30th until December the 23rd. So in between, so on the exam day of scientific communication, the day will be used for your poster presentation submission. Okay, you must submit the poster and also you must submit the presentation video. Okay, presentation video and also the presentation video and also the poster itself. Okay, so we haven't got the exact date for our final exam, but the range, we knew that it is from 30th from December the 30th until the December the 23rd. So be ready for working on the poster and the topic of your poster presentation. I will send you after the finishing of your 10 minutes presentation. Okay, and the full paper. Okay, the full paper, this one, it is submitted on the last day, okay, of the presentation trip. The last day of presentation trip. Okay, so we already done with literature review, and we're going to have a 3 minutes presentation starting Thursday, and then continuing to the 10 minutes presentation and 15 minute presentation, full paper and poster. Okay, so looking at our schedule, we are here at October the 5th, talking about the grammatical and content revision of your paper, and then see the progress of your presentation for Thursday. Okay, so these are the schedule. Okay, don't worry, I will upload this into the EduNix. Okay, don't forget to access regularly the EduNix websites, because all of the resources that you need in order to pass this class is already given in the EduNix LMS. Okay, from the schedule, from the references, from the course material, etc., and so on. So please visit them regularly. Okay, is there any question at the moment from the student?
Sir, I want to ask.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
About your comment in my paper introduction that. Mm-hmm. We need to discuss about this.
Oh, okay. So this is wait a minute. This is Khalda. Okay, Khalda. Let me see the feedback. Okay, Khalda. Where is Khalda? Ah, okay. So here, I noticed that the writings of your introduction is kind of strange for me, because let me enlarge this, maximize this. Okay. Okay, the COVID-19 pandemic is a global threat. Okay, well, at least you need to have references for this. And then this disease can affect anyone without exception. The cause of COVID is SARS-CoV-2, Infection of SARS-CoV-2 virus into the human body can result in lower respiratory tract infections and progress to severe acute respiratory syndrome, multiple organ failure, and even death. And here, this is the thing that I want to discuss with you. Why do you have this one? Coronavirus infection, COVID-19, period. What does this mean? Can you explain?
I think it's about intro, about COVID, not...
Well, you already have introduction here, right? You already...
Yes, sir.
Yeah, but what is this? I mean, where do you get this? Where do you get this? Is it coming from a certain publications or what? Because it is...
It's intro about COVID-19, sir.
Yeah, but it's not common. It is. Yeah. But what does this? What is the purpose? What is the purpose of this phrase over here? Okay, because you already have introduction on top, so we knew that this section will be the background story of your paper, right? So this doesn't have any purpose at all. So it makes me wonder whether you are copying from another source or what, because this is one example. And then let me see. Long time conclusion analysis. This one, it's kind of strange for me because you have this phrase that it doesn't have any purpose at all. So I'm just going to verify. Okay, I'm just going to verify with you whether it is coming out from a certain publication or you may. A literature review that is coming out from many references, because I noticed here that you only have two. Okay, you only have two references. Okay, so this one is need to be corrected because it is not source but references, like this one. Okay, so you don't write it as source but write it as references, and then. I'm just wondering whether you write this introduction based on a literature review work, or you just copy and paste the material from the original source. Can you comment on that?
From search tool and from the references. This from Kegel that explanations decoding.
Which this one, the coronavirus infections.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I mean, please be aware that whenever you copy and paste a certain material from original source, make sure that you already editing. You already edit the content so that. When you are presenting this into the for review, for example, this type of mistake is not obvious. Okay, because here it makes me as the reviewer question whether the manuscript here it is written from literature review or it is just copy and paste from other, because I'm suspecting that this is coming out from a certain title of a subsection on a certain publication, so this shouldn't be exist in this manuscript. Okay. So, comma set effect. So, is it the original paper? So, is the original source? It is written in Indonesian or is written in English?
In English, sure.
In English,
but I'm paraphrase.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, all right. So, for a long time, the use of deep learning, especially convolutional neural systems, CNN. I think it is convolutional neural network. This one, CNN.
Yeah.
It, yes. It is not convolutional neural system. If it's convolutional neural system, it could be a CNS. Okay. And then here you also use convolutional neural arrange for CNN, but it is not. It is not correct. So you, if you already stated a CNN in the bar, okay. So for example, this CNN over here should be written here for convolutional neural network, and then followed by the CNN, and then the convolutional neural system. You can still use this, okay, but without using the CNN, okay. Or you just write this specifically CNN has effectively outperformed conventional machine learning in image classification, etc., and so on. Okay, so please be careful with the details of your writings, because I'm guessing here that the CNN is more suitable for this one, convolutional neural network, instead of convolutional neural system. Okay. AI is from artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence, right? So AI. Let me see. Counterfeit insight. AI here is should be on a artificial intelligence on somewhere. Let me see. Find artificial intelligence. Artificial. Okay, there are none artificial intelligence written in the manuscript. So I guess if you are talking about counterfeit insight, it is not AI but CI, right? CI. I don't know whether the original paper consider counterfeit insight as a part of artificial intelligence, but if it's a part of artificial intelligence, that it should be written as counterfeit insight, which is a one method or one mechanism of artificial intelligence bracket AI. Okay, so that's why we need to discuss a little bit about your writing, is because there are some kind of a confusion that I feel as the reviewer. Okay, regarding your introduction. Okay, for long time, the use of definitional CNN has effectively outperformed. Okay, you already know it. It is extremely difficult to analyze X-ray filters. Tech decision is imminent. PyTorch is domestic. So, what is PyTorch? PyTorch is domestic for new. What does this mean? PyTorch is domestic for numerous effective ventures and future inquire about. I don't get it. Okay, I don't understand this sentence. PyTorch is domestic. What is the original source? What is the original sentence for this statement? PyTorch is domestic.
It's some applications that Python, it's not false, sir.
Okay, so it's an application that was created under Python.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. Sir.
Okay. So, but what is domestic here? What does domestic means here? I just don't understand.
Similar, yeah. It's not, not true, sir.
Okay. So, is it what does the original sentence for this one? Is it you say it is written in English? PyTorch is domestic.
Yes, sir. In English.
In English, PyTorch is domestic for numerous. Effective ventures and future inquires about profound learning and fake insight. Yeah, but it is strange. Domestic. Well, domestic means Domestic means local, right? Domestic means local. Well, is it okay for you? So, are you using PyTorch for? So, is the publication that you are going to present is basically use PyTorch for analyzing the COVID spread? Is it using PyTorch? For the study? Okay, so I'm just going to recommend you to revise this one, okay?
Okay, sir.
Revise this sentence because it doesn't make any sense. Even if you are translating this into Indonesian, okay? If you are translating this into Indonesian, it still doesn't make any logic. I cannot understand that, okay, I could not understand this sentence even though it is translated into Indonesian. So so make sure that you revise this one and then you look for other sentences whether it's logical or not, because it has to be logical because we are writing a scientific paper, not a story, okay, not a bedtime story. Facebook AI inquire about reasonable contributed. Okay. Contributed or contribution? I guess this is the contribution.
Contribution.
So you may be able to see and create your poses state of the art program motivating from ventures. What is ventures? Ventures. Yeah, I guess so that's why I need us to discuss a little bit about this one because this paragraph especially needs some kind of a further thinking because some of the sentence is not logical at all because I could not understand even if I'm translating this into Indonesian, the meanings of the words itself is kind of strange. Okay, it's kind of strange. So just revise this. Okay, revise this. So look for this paragraph especially because you need to make some kind of a logical thread. Okay, a logical timeline or logical order so that this sentence is meaningful to the introduction itself. Okay, so the goals of the analysis in this research are also expected to identify the features and characteristics of the lungs of the patient who are confirm positive for COVID. Okay, so this is the aims of the publication in order to verify that there is some kind of COVID-19 infection inside of the lung. This method won't say computer can outperform with absolute precision, so you need to include a conjunction here, but or however, it may have failed in some cases. That's why we have computer to assist doctor and can be considered and can be for verification and validation by medical personnel so that in the future it hope that it can be applied to support clinical. Okay, so how many sentences here? 1, 2, 3. Okay, my suggestion for the last sentence of the last paragraph, you can make it 2 sentences because it's too long. And then the way that you make it now as a complex or a compound sentences is not that good. So I think you need to just separate between the computers and doctor assistants and about the support clinical diagnosis of COVID-19. So you can make it as a two separate sentences, or you still write this as a compound or a complex sentence but with the proper conjunctions, okay, and the proper example, punctuation, etc., and so on, like comma or something, because I think it's too long. Okay, if you, I think you need to put some kind of a comma on some after some part, because that's why we have computer to assist doctor and can be considered for a vacation and validation by medical personnel, comma. So in the future, so you don't need to have that here. So in the future, we hope that computer assisted can be applied to support clinical diagnosis of COVID-19, right? So this is better. So if you're going to, write this as a compound sentence, you can change it into that one using comma, etc., and so on. But if not, then just make it two different sentences, because one is talking about doctors and verification validation, and the other one is that the computer hopefully can be applied to support clinical diagnosis, because it's two separate ideas. Okay. Okay.
Okay, sir.
I think that's all for Hauda. Okay. Can I now call a random name to show me your presentation draft? Okay. So I have turned on the multiple sharing option from Zoom. So I would like you to show me the draft of your presentation slide, if it's possible. Okay, so I will start calling names from the 24 students listed on the SIX attendance list. Okay, so Rifki Nafis. Rifki Nafis.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Do you have your draft ready?
It's actually ready, but today I'm running my Zoom in my mobile phone because the laptop is kinda hang.
Oh, okay.
So it is starting right now.
Okay, okay. Make sure that you are ready on Thursday or Tuesday, because I'm going to call a student's name randomly for this assignment. It's going to be different when we're going to have the 15 minutes presentation, where a list of names will be done their presentation in order. But for 3 minutes and 10 minutes presentation, I will call the student's name randomly, so that student needs to be prepared for their presentation. Okay, so if you are having trouble, then I'm just going to move on to another name. Jovan Ezra, is Jovan in the classroom?
Yes, sir.
Okay, is it possible for you to show me your presentation draft?
Actually, I haven't started working on it yet, sir.
Oh, okay. Okay. So I'm moving on to Balia. Balia Elfata.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you show me your presentation draft?
I too haven't worked on the presentation draft too, sir.
Okay. Okay. Moving on to Muhri Iza. Is there Muhri Ihza in the classroom? Okay, there are no Muhri. So moving on to Ratih Pratiwi.
Yes.
Hello, Ratih. Hello. Okay, could you show me your presentation draft? Okay, I am going to stop here. Okay, Rati is going to talk about electrical resistivity tomography on geothermal sites, right?
No, sir. I changed my...
Oh, you changed your topic into what? Let me see.
It's about shale gas.
Oh, about shale gas. Okay, let me... Rati Pratiwi... Monitoring CO2 storage and enhance. Oh, okay. In unconfirmed. Okay, monitoring CO2 storage. Okay. Okay, could you show us your draft? CO2.
Oh, but I think it's not the final one, sir.
Yeah, it's okay. It's okay.
Okay. Mm. Okay.
Because I'm just going to look for the progress. CO2 monitoring. CO2 monitoring. CO2 monitoring in enhanced EOR. Show guys. Okay. Okay. So you made six. Oh, okay. Okay. So for presentation templates, I haven't asked you to use a specific template. Even though I kind of share to you on the Google Drive folder. The same template that you found for the paper and also the presentation. So if you're going to use the EduNext template for this assignment, then it is fine, okay? But I haven't asked you to use specific template because the setting for the 3 minutes talk is just to introduce the audience about your topic. And talk about the background story of the topic itself. Okay, so regarding this one, okay, so what I'm suggesting you to do, can you make the title and your affiliation a little bit separate? I mean the title. In terms of the visual, I think it is better for you to make the title a little bit upper, okay, a little bit upper, yeah, and then increasing the size of the, but not too much, and for aesthetics, you can use blue color. You can use blue color. I think that's highlighting. Okay. You can use dark blue or a little bit light blue. So if you this is dark blue, right? So if you use ordinary blue, what will happen? Let me see. Yeah, this is okay. Okay, this is in terms of the visuals. Okay, in terms of the visuals, this look better compared to the previous one that you use all black color for the fonts. Okay, and then here, what I'm suggesting you to do is that please separate your names and your ID number. You may write it as Ratih Pratiwi first, and then your registration number in the following line, okay, in the bottom, yeah, there, with NIM, for example, or ID number, NIM, or, okay, yeah, and then the affiliation will be Physics of Earth and Complex System, okay, so Division, Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Sciences, yeah, this is good, okay, next, okay, let me see, next one, okay, slide number two. Can you move to slide Lisa, number two.
For the yeah, slides.
Uh-huh.
Do I have to change the color?
No, I guess using black color is good in terms of the visual. But what I'm suggesting you to do is to enlarge the size of your name, Pratih Pratiwi. Increase the size of the font or make it bold. Yeah, like that one. Yeah. Not the ID. No. Only your names. Okay. Only your names. What is the size of your names and the ID number and the affiliations? 18. So that is 18. Okay. Could you make it increase a little bit in the name? Only the name. Again. Make it 22 or 24. Okay, this is better. So you don't need to make it blue because it just because the names could be in terms of the visual, this is better. Okay, because people will knew that the will knew directly. Okay, we'll knew instantly that the presenter's name is Ratih Pratiwi, and then Ratih is going to talk about the monitoring of CO2 storage. Okay, could you move on to the sorry, what did you do that? And enhance space. Ah, okay, this one. Okay, slide number two. Okay, slide number two, you have that slide number properly, okay? Okay, what I'm suggesting you here is don't use a sentence because presentation, it is not a paper, okay? The one that I show you on the lecture note is a lecture, okay? But you are not giving a lecture. You're going to present a short talk or a scientific talk that costs for 15 minutes, 10 minutes, and 3 minutes. So never use sentences, okay? I'm suggesting you for this one is to use a certain phrase and then you're talking about that from your voice, okay? So as one resource energy can be used, because people who is attending your talk will not read this one, okay? Will not read because presentation is the time for you to basically present yourself, right? It is not the time for the audience to read the materials in the front because they attend the meeting for seeing you're talking about certain topics, right? So please go to the slide number three. Yes, this is also my suggestion is that don't use this one because you still have too many sentences. Can you make some kind of a figure that tells everybody about the CO2 storage or enhanced gas recovery operation, etc., and so on? Because if this is done in this format, then the presentation itself will not encourage people to see the talk. People will not interest. People will not get interested in your talk because it's full of letters instead of visuals, etc. And so, okay. So let me see for especially I see in the slide number five, it's too many sentences. Let us go to slide number five. Okay. Ah, here it is. It's too many words. People will not attend your talk if you it's just like you're having a lecture instead of a presentation. Okay. So even though I'm sure that what you're going to talk about in the introduction is basically the background story of why CO2 injection, or why does CO2 storage is needed in this time around, and then what is the application of the CO2 injection of a certain reservoir, especially to increase the production, especially those hydrocarbon who are trapped into a certain small pores of rock, for example, but make them fish, make them present in terms of visual, okay? Because what you are working now is that people, because here you kind of make the audience or the attendee of a seminar to read your your topics, okay? So presentation is not to make people read your topic. It's the time for you to present yourself, that I'm working on it, that I understand about this topic, and then you make address to the audience that this topic is important. Okay, so if it's done like this way, using these whole sentences, your message will not. Your message will not come through to the audience, because it's too many sentences here. Instead of attending a talk, they could read the manuscript instead if you present the material with these sentences. Okay.
Okay, I see, sir. Thank you very much.
Okay. Okay, you're welcome. You're welcome. Thank you for sharing your draft. Okay, hopefully in Tuesday and Thursday the visual will be better compared to this one. Okay, thank you. That is Rati, right? CO2 monitoring in EOR of shale gas. Okay, could we move on to Anggita? Is Anggita in the classroom?
To be honest, I have not working on it.
Okay. So let us move on to. Okay, could we move on to Arfian? Is Arfian in the classroom? Okay. Yes. Could you show us your draft?
I'm not start yet. Sorry, sir.
Okay. Muhammad Ridho Nurul Ihsan.
I'm sorry, sir. I haven't prepared the draft.
Okay, Zafiri Fadli, Johari. Zafiri Fadli, is Zafiri in the classroom? Okay, I'm calling Zafiri. Is Zafiri in the classroom? Okay, Hans, is Hans Timothy in the classroom?
Yes, sir.
Okay, could you show us your draft?
Not yet, sir.
Okay, not yet. Okay, Nabila Safri Ramdhani.
Sorry, sir, I haven't prepared yet.
Okay, so why does. Okay, Rifka Rahayu.
I haven't started yet.
Okay, Nermina.
Sorry, sir, I'm still drafting. And
have but have you have some kind of. Fadila Rizalul Yahya.
Sorry, I haven't prepared yet.
Okay, well, okay, since many of you haven't done with your, okay, let me see the schedule. Okay, so, how to create presentation slides. Okay, so here was going. Here what we're going to do. Please be ready with your presentation draft. And we're going to evaluate your draft on Thursday instead. So I can move this. I can rearrange our 3 minutes presentation. Instead of starting on Thursday, we'll start on next Tuesday itself. So okay, so I'm changing the schedule for the presenters workshop on Thursday. Okay, let me see. Presenters workshop. Now I see. Okay, so be ready with your presentation draft on Thursday so that I could look at your topic and the way that you are preparing for your visuals. Okay, no color. Okay, so in Thursday, presenters workshop. Okay. Okay, we're going to have a presenter workshops on Thursday, and then be ready with your presentation draft. And so we could start our 3 minutes presentation next week. Okay, in 3 minutes. Okay, in 3 minutes talk from 24 students. Okay, I've already see Pratiwi's draft, but since we're going to make a specific workshop on Thursday, so I'm asking Ratih also to show her review, so not review, corrections from today's feedback. Okay, so with that, I'm just going to change the schedule. Okay, change the schedule into this one. Okay, so we're not going to have the second presenter workshop before the beginning of 10 minutes presentation. We're going to, please write this date. Okay, the day for your 3 minutes presentation will be done in October the 11th, okay, and sorry, October the 12th, okay, October the 12th and October the 14th, and then your 10 minutes presentation will be start in October the 25th, October the 26th, because October the 25th is Monday, well, our class is in Tuesday, so 10 minutes presentation will be done on October the 26th, October the 28th, and November the 2nd and November the 4th. Okay, so okay, please look up for this new schedule. Next Thursday, please be ready with your presentation draft. Okay, presentation slides draft, so that I could evaluate your readiness for your 3 minutes presentation, and then in next week we are starting our 3 minutes presentation. Okay, is there any more question from students? Okay, these are our schedule for the next week. Okay, if there are no questions, I will stop our lecture now. Okay, I'm stopping the recording. Mm-hmm.